Good morning and assalamu alaikum students. Take out your language tree book and page number is 26. Today we are going to start a poem. Page number 26. Language tree book page number 26. I have mentioned on the board and we are going to start unit number 5, which is poem. So let's start. What is the poem? What the poem is about? Okay, this is about a dancing poinsettia, which is a tree, very beautiful and very colorful tree. See, this tree has a pink color, blue color, and yellow color flowers on it, and it is really very huge, big tree with a beautiful colors of flowers on it. This is poinsettia, dancing poinsettia. This is the tree. It is very, very, very beautiful tree. So I would like to ask you people, what is your favorite flower and how would you describe it? And what do you like about it? Whether it is a flower or a tree, which flower or tree would you like? And what is your favorite flower and why you like it? See, these are the 3 to 4 questions which you have to remind it in your mind, and then you will have to tell me which is your favorite flower and why it is your favorite flower. It could be a flower or also a tree. Okay, so you will start with reading the poem. Fire in the treetops. Treetops, the upper part of the tree. The most upper part, सबसे ऊपर वाला जो हिस्सा होता है दरख्त का, that is called tree, fire, tree tops. Fire in the sky, blossoms as red as sunset. Now, in this poem, they are using this comparison of two things for this tree. इस दरख्त के बारे में explain किया हुआ है by using the contrast of comparing of two words. Okay, that blossoms and red as sunset. Sunset is like orange and yellow. Blossoms, it is a flower that appear on tree before the food. It is like red kind of flower which appears on the tree without before a food is before the food. So the tree is like blossoms as sunset. And dazzling to the bright. Dazzling means extremely bright to the eyes. These are very, very bright colors in this tree. So these are dazzling to the eye. These are very bright colors to the eyes, and it looks very beautiful, and you feel very beautiful and charged up and energetic when you look at those flowers, when you look at that beautiful trees. Dance poinsettia, sway poinsettia on a sea of green. Now, what is the meaning of sway? Move forward or backward or from side to side. जब हवा चलती है तरफ इधर उधर आगे पीछे चलता है ना, so dancing with that's why we call it dancing poinsettia. कि जब हवा चलती है तो दरख्त हिलता है साइड से आगे पीछे और उसके फूल नीचे गिरते हैं. Sway poinsettia, regal as a green. Now regal is used for king and queen, and they are using this, comparing this regal word with queens. It is a very special and suitable word for king and queen. Fire in the treetops. Treetops, upper part of tree. Fire in the sky. Crimson petals and white. Now, what are crimson? A rich, deep red color. Crimson is red, rich, deep red color. Crimson, rich, deep red color. Now, the petals are of rich, deep red color and white, stained with scarlet dye. And there are kind of stain on it, on these flowers. Of a scarlet means bright red color, and there are drops of bright red colors on this flower. Now they are giving us the uh, details of the flower which are on this Ponciana. They are crimson petals, bright red color, and there is white on it, and there are stained patches of red color on it as well. Dance Ponciana, sway Ponciana on a sea of green. Dance Ponciana, sway Ponciana, regal as a queen. Now they have given us the explanation of this very, very beautiful tree. This is a Ponciana tree. Why we call it Dance Ponciana tree? When the wind blows, the tree moves forward and backward, upside and side to side. So those flowers fell off from this tree. So that's why we call it Dance Ponciana. And the flowers are very beautiful. There are many colors of flowers on these trees. Purple, red and yellow color of flowers we have on these trees. And the flowers are also in multicolors, like red, dark red and scarlet red, crimson, white. These 3 to 4 colors that are on these flowers. So now, we can see here the 5 senses that are see, hear, taste, smell and touch. Now look at this page number 27, question number 1. Page 27 and this question number 1. Speaking and listening. This is just for your oral exercise, speaking and listening. Discuss the answer to this question. What do you like about this poem? Do you think the poet likes looking at the tree? Do you like looking at the trees or not? Now we have 5 senses. What are those? See, hear, listen, smell and touch. We can see this tree. We can listen this when the wind blows. We can listen to voice as well. We can touch these trees. We can smell the fragrance of flower. So these are the 5 kinds of senses which are also used in this. I hope you have already studied these senses. These are listen, hear, speak, see and touch. These are the 5 senses which we can can feel. Now take out page number 28. This page number 28. Take out page number 28. Now what is it? Look at question number 3. Talk to your partner about things you like to hear, taste, touch and smell. Now your partner can be your mother, your sister, your father or your brother. You just have to talk about them, about these senses, like what you like to hear, what you like to taste, what you like to listen and what you like to smell. Like these are some of the examples given here. I like to smell some bread. Like some people like the smell of fresh bread. That fragrance is really, really very, very, very aromatic and very, very good. I like to touch baby chicks. Well, I also like to touch baby chicks. These are the baby chicks. So I hope every one of you like to touch. You are not scared of it. These are really, really little cute baby chicks, and I really, really like to touch them and play with them. I hope you also do the same. I like to hear the sound of a sea. How many of you like to hear the sound of sea? Like, I like to hear the sound of sea. I like to hear the sound of wind. So I hope anyone of you also like the sound of sea. If you have ever been to the sea, which we only have in Karachi, if you have been to Karachi, if you have been to sea, so you would have listened the sound of sea, the sound of waves when the waves come near to you. So I really, really enjoy those things. I like to hear the sound of sea. So I would like to ask you people, what are those sounds which you like to hear, or which you like to taste, or which you like to smell or touch? I like to taste chicken soup. Here is also this is a sense of tasting. I like to taste chicken soup. So what are the things which you like to taste? So you have to speak about these things to your partners. I have told you about my things, and I want you people to talk these things about with your partners at home, with your mother, father, brother or sister. So you have to discuss with them what taste you like, or what things you want to touch. So you have to discuss this with your parents or with your siblings. Now look at this question number one. The exercise. Now we are going to start the exercise. Page number 28, question number 1. Present continuous. Previously we have done present tense. Now we are going to start with present continuous. What is present continuous? We have done present tense and past tense. Now this is present continuous. The tense, the things which are ongoing in the present. Like I am teaching you. This is the present. What I am doing is I am teaching you. I am continuously teaching you. मैं आपको continuously पढ़ा रही हूँ. तो present tense में काम हो रहा है. तो जो भी काम present में हो रहा होता है continuously, इसको हम present tense में लेके आते हैं. जैसे मैं आपको पढ़ा रही हूँ, आप lecture ले रहे हो. This is these two both things are going in present tense. So we have to complete this sentence. Now what are the main ingredient which we use in the present continuous tense? Those are, we add ing at the end. Page number 28, we are on page number 28, present continuous. What is present continuous? The verb which is ongoing in present. And what are the most the structure of this present continuous tense? It is, we add ing with verb. We add ing with verb, like play. So we will add ing at the end. It will be play. I am playing. I am teaching. From teach to teaching. From teach to teaching. Now the verb which ends with E, we just drop E and add ing. जो वर्ब जिनके एंड में ई आता है तो हम ई को कट करके उसमें आई एन जी एड करते हैं. लाइक डांस. व्हाट विल बी द कंटिन्यूअस फॉर्म ऑफ डांस? इट विल बी डांसिंग. सो वी विल रिमूव ई एंड वी विल ऐड आई एन जी. वी विल रिमूव ई एंड वी विल ऐड आई एन जी एट द एंड. Some verbs double the last letter, like hope, and it will become hoping. In some letters, we add, we double the last word. In some verbs, we remove the e, which are ending with e, and we just add ing with it. And in the rest of the cases, we just add ing at the end. Now look at this exercise and complete this exercise with me on the books. आपको अभी ये exercise मेरे साथ books पे complete करनी है. You have to complete these exercise with me on the book right now. Question number one, page number 28. We are on page number 28 during the exercise. Now look at this. Complete the sentences with am, is, or are. You know we use am, is, or are in the continuous sentences. So we are going to use this in the sentences now. Look at number one. Sentence number one. The tree dashed swaying in the wind. The tree is plural. So what we will use is the tree is swaying in the wind. The tree is, in the blank you will write is. The tree is swaying in the wind. Look at number two. The flowers dash dancing on the tree. Now flowers is plural. So what we will use with plural? We use are with plurals. I have told you in the last lecture we use is for singular verbs and are for plural verbs. The flowers are dancing on the tree. Now look at number three. We dash looking at the flowers in the tree. We is plural, so we will use are. We is plural, so we will use are with it. I dash listening to the wind in the trees. I is singular, so we will use am with it. I am listening to the wind in the trees. Number five. Grandmother dash tasting that chicken soup. Grandmother is singular. So what we will use with it is grandmother is tasting the chicken soup. Number six. Dash. You all listening asked our teacher. So you all is plural. So what we will use with it? Are. Are you all listening to the teacher? Ask. Are you all listening? Ask the teacher. Now look at page number 29. Take out page number 29. I hope you all have taken out page number 29 and question number 2. What we have to do is add ing to these verbs, copy and complete the tables. Now you have to make a table like this of three columns and you have to take words from them and you have to complete add ing at the end of them. Now make sure to double the word which are ending with p, remove e and add ing with it. Like this, I will give you one example. The first word is race. The first word is race. You will remove e, r-a-c-e-v, race. You will remove e and just add ing with it. It will be racing. E ko remove karke ing lagayenge, racing ban jayega. Likewise, drop. The last word is drop. You will add it, you will add the last word, you will do the last word double. You will double the last word by drop. It will be dropping. The word with the ending with P, you will double them, dropping. And the word which are ending with E, you will just cut the E and add ing with them. And you have to make the column, three columns, and you have to see these words and add ing at the end. Now look at question number 3. Choose two words from each column in the table above. Write each one in a sentence using the present continuous. Now when you will make three different columns, now one for simple adding ing and one for removing e and adding ing and one for doubling the last word like running, dropping, putting, telling. So these will be in this column, double the last word. So after doing this column thing, you will pick two words from each column. जब आप ये कॉलम बना लेंगे, जब आपने इन वर्ड्स को भी यहाँ पे सेपरेट करके लिख लिया, उसके बाद हर कॉलम से दो दो वर्ड्स आप लेंगे और उनको अपने सेंटेंस में यूज करेंगे, प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस सेंटेंस में. ओके, हर कॉलम से जब आप ये वर्ड्स को कॉलम्स में डिफरेंटली ऐड कर लोगे, हर कॉलम से दो दो वर्ड्स आप लोगे और उन कॉलम्स को आप प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस में सेंटेंसेस के तौर पे यूज करोगे. So this is question number 2 and 3. This is the same thing, but you just have to make sentences by using two words. So aapke do 6 sentences ban jayenge, 2 to 4 to 6 sentences aapko ban jayenge. Okay, but the sentences must be in present continuous tense. Now, what are rhyming words? Rhyming words are those words which sounds the same. जिनके words भी different होते हैं, meanings भी different होते हैं, but दोनों के sound same होते हैं. What are rhyming words which sound same? आवाज दोनों की same होती, sound same होता है, but meanings और words दोनों different होते हैं. Now look at this question number 2 on page number 29. Page number 29 and question number 2. Page number 29 and question number 2 we are doing. We have to sort out the rhyming words between these. Okay, now you have to write the numbers on it. Okay, 1, 1. जो दोनों नंबर, जो दोनों वर्ड सेम हो गए ना, दोनों के ऊपर आपने 1, 1 लिख देना है. फिर हम जब सेकंड वर्ड करेंगे तो दोनों वर्ड सेम होंगे, उनके ऊपर आपने 2, 2 लिख देना है. और जब थर्ड हम करेंगे, थर्ड का जब सेम होगा, उसके ऊपर आपने दोनों के ऊपर 3 लिख देना है. जैसे कि लुक एट दिस, नंबर 1, बोट, होम, फ्लोट, क्लोज, फोम, नोज. दीज आर द 6 वर्ड्स विच राइम विद ईच अदर. तो हमने इनका पेयर्स बना लेंगे, पेयर्स में बना लेंगे. अब नंबर 1, बोट. नाउ फाइंड आउट द राइमिंग वर्ड ऑफ बोट. बोट होम, नो, बोट एंड होम दे बोथ आर नॉट सेम, डोंट ट्राई. बोट फ्लोट, yes, boat and float, these two are rhyming words, they sound the same. Boat, float. Now I will write number 1 on boat and number 1 on float. Un dono ka humne pair banana hai, to dono ke upar aap kya likh doge? 1, 1. Boat, float. Home, close. No, home or close, no, they are not rhyming. Home, form. Home, form. Write number 2 on home and number 2 on form. So this will be the second pair. And third pair is close and nose. Close, nose. This is the third pair. Close, nose. Boat, float, one pair. Home, form, second pair. Close, nose is third pair. Like using the same pattern, same तरीके से आप number 2 और number 3 करोगे. Same pattern से number 2 और number 3 आप करोगे. Okay. Now look at question number 3 on page number 29. Question number 3, page number 29. Complete the sentences with suitable rhymes. Now bold letters are given, we have to rhyme words with them. ये हमें बोल्ड लेटर्स में जो वर्ड्स यू हैं इनके साथ हमने क्या करनी है, राइमिंग करनी है. नाउ व्हाट, हाउ वी विल डू, The cook is looking in a book. Cook, book. These two are the same word. Write book in this plan. Cook, book. The cook is looking in a book. Page number 29, question number 3. The cook is looking in a book. I can see three birds in the tree. I can see three birds in the tree. Write tree. Tree and tree. These both words rhyme with each other. There are five bees in the hive. Bees, five and hive, H-I-V-E, hive. Five, hive. The farmer hits his toe with a hoe. H-O-E, hoe. Toe, the rhyming word of toe is hoe. H-O-E, hoe. The frog is sitting on a log. Frog, log. L-O-G, log. The frog is sitting on log. L-O-G, log. I am going to bake a cake. Bake, cake. The rhyming word of bake is cake. Now I am repeating again only the words which are used in the sentences so that you can recheck them. In the first sentence, we have used book. In second sentence, tree. Third sentence, hive, H-I-V-E, hive. Fourth sentence, hoe, H-O-E, hoe. Fifth sentence, log, L-O-G, log. Sixth sentence is cake, C-A-K-E, cake. Take out page number 30, the last page. Page number 30. Now you have to choose the words from here, similes. What are similes? Similes are used to compare a person or a thing to something else. We compare a person or a thing to something else. हम किसी एक इंसान को या किसी चीज को किसी और दूसरे चीज के साथ जब हम कंपेयर करते हैं उसका मुवासना करते हैं तो वो क्या कहलाता है सिमिली. It helps to paint a picture in our mind, like As fresh as flowers. He is looking as fresh as flowers. And as run as fast as a rabbit. So these are, we are comparing two things, one thing to another thing. And in similes, we only use like and as. Like and as. He swims like a fish. She was as busy as a bee. So these are the two examples of similes. Similes are comparing a person or a thing to something else. Now look at this page number 30, these plants. My big brother is as brave as a lion. So you just have to use these words from above and you have to fill these blanks. Lion, in the first plank you will write lion. Ahmed climbed up the tree like a cat. Rida can cycle as fast as the wind. The water was as cold as ice. The baby's skin felt soft like silk. The lights were as bright as jewels. Lion, cat, wind, ice, silk, jewel. We have used these words and we have filled in the blank. Now look at this last question, and this is very important question to understand. What you have to do is, write a poem about your favorite tree or flower. Your poem does not need to rhyme. जरूरी नहीं है कि आपकी poem भी sequence में rhyme करे, जैसे इसमें rhyme कर रही थी. Make a poem, जो भी words आपके mind में आते हैं. Like it is, this is a poem. The rose is my favorite tree. I love it. Smell, they look like cabbage. I like it best when it rains. So you have to use the words of your own. जरूरी नहीं है जो words मैंने बताए हैं वही use करें. You can use any word in these sentences and you have to make a card of this poem, of your poem. Now look at these pointers carefully. I am reading for you. Name a flower, name of tree or flower, part of tree or flower. What this part of the tree or flower looks like. Describe the weather. Say what the tree or flower looks like or something it does. These are the examples given to you to fill these blanks. इनको आपने पढ़ के ये blanks fill करनी है with the help of your elder sisters or parents. And the last and most important thing is check your poem carefully. After completing this poem on the book, what you have to do is cut out a piece of card in the shape of your tree or flower. Copy your poem onto the card. Now you have to make a small card. Of cardboard or of a chart paper or on a paper or on A4 sheet, but it should be a shape of a card. It should be of your favorite tree or flower. जैसे यहाँ पे rose लिखा हुआ है, उन्होंने rose की so you have to cut a card of a rose shape and you have to paste this poem on that paper on that rose. And if you have any favorite tree, तो आपने उस tree की shape में card को cut करना है और अपने इस पोएम को उस कार्ड के ऊपर पेस्ट कर देना। आई एम राइटिंग द होमवर्क ऑन द बोर्ड सो दैट इट वुड बी इजी टू यू। जस्ट पेज नंबर 29, question 2. From page number 30, I have given you question number 1 and 2. These two questions, this question will be done on the book. And this is the question which you have to do as a creative work. And on page number 29, question number 2, make a table. And question number 3, make sentences from, take two words from each column and you have to make sentences. So if you have any questions regarding this, you can ask me now.